Hey folks, it's going to be a little awkward because I'm going to be holding the camera while I try to unwrap this, but I did promise everyone that I would do a unboxing video, so here goes nothing. As you can see, here's the Horus Heresy box for Ingron. Pretty much a black box. Of course, the sticker saying, hey, this is what it is and what batch number and all the good stuff. Other than that, it's pretty much... just a black box. It says Horus Heresy on it. And I'm going to take a guess that this is how pretty much all of the different... all of the Horus Heresy stuff is going to end up coming out. Now this thing comes in at a price of about 50 pounds, so it's not cheap. Or easy to get out of the box, it would seem. So here we go. First thing you see is a hanger. Kind of makes me scratch my head as to why you would get a hanger. Hanger's nothing really to write home about, kind of flimsy. Now here's the rest of it. You got the large round base. The actual base itself that it sits on. You got a small one that the model itself sits on. You have this smaller topper that Ingron himself will sit on. So that's the base stuff. And I do have to say it's pretty damn detailed. Pretty much if you've had Forge World before, you know what it looks like. It looks like one of the dead space marines that Ingron is stepping on in the photos is actually molded into the base himself. The detail's pretty damn fantastic. Now, if you've seen photos of this, you'll know that he's actually knocking over several space marines, so you get all the body parts and the pieces of the space marines themselves. Done in the proper armor and stuff. Another one of the So there is all the random small pieces and body parts and stuff that you get for the model. Now let's go ahead and move on to Engron himself. I do see one minor problem. Oh, no, actually it's not. I thought my axe was broke. Turns out the axe purposely comes in two pieces. If you see, there's a little slotted hole. And then there is the little nub at the end. So I was a little worried that my axe got broke. Nope. Turns out it's supposed to be like that. Now, I don't know if this was intentional or not, but they did send me two arms. Actually, I'm pretty sure it was intentional. It looks like... No? They sent me two arms. I don't know, there's no obvious miscast on this one, which is usually why they would do it. Of course, there's the other arm. With Gore Child and Gore Father. So, I guess I got an extra Engron arm. Kind of curious. Just kind of tossed in there. Alright, now you got probably two of the best looking pieces. You got Engron, and then you have his cloak. The cloak, from what I'm looking at my viewfinder to what I see in real life, it's hard to describe. You got a whole bunch of intricate little chains. That's what the little weave pattern looks like. Those are a whole bunch of little chains, most of them ending in skulls. And, I mean, the cloak is absolutely beautiful. Really impressed with the sculpting work that went into getting the cloak. And they got Engron himself. You got the icon on the top for World Eaters, of course. His armor's really kind of unadorned. And mine does have a little bit of miscasting. But it shouldn't be too hard to fix. Now, Engron does have actually some Aquila icons on the back of the headdress. And then also as a belt, he has an Aquila as well. But, you know, his armor itself is kind of not all that fancy, but going with his background, I think that fits in really well with the character. For it not being all that detailed, it still is really detailed and looks really nice. And I can just imagine how awesome it is going to be to put this one together and paint it. I'll probably actually end up spending more time painting the base than I will the Engron himself. He doesn't look like he's going to be all that difficult to paint up. And he's put together quite nicely, or as far as pieces coming apart and stuff. Having Gore Father being a separate piece is a nice touch. And then Gore Child, of course, is on miniature itself. Even the scenery, the base itself is really beautifully done and beautifully cast. Alright, if you want to hear more about this miniature, I'll be talking about it over at the Screaming Heretic. not including shipping. So I'll be talking about whether or not I think it's a good deal, give my feelings on the model a little bit. But here you go. There's the breakdown of Angron.